All right, he went from flying helicopters in Iraq to running a successful business before throwing his hat in the ring for the Michigan Senate seat.
And now this political newcomer getting a pretty big endorsement from incoming National Security Advisor John Bolton. That Iraq War vet and Republican from Michigan, he's running for Senate. John James joins us right now from Detroit. John, good morning to you.
Good morning to you as well, Stephen.
Okay, did you know that John Bolton was going to endorse you?
Well, no. We met a couple of times. In our last meeting, we spoke a lot about my experience at West Point and understanding conventional war and understanding how the world is set up, some of the threats that are facing us now and in the future. We talked about my experience as a Ranger qualified Apache pilot who's flown in actual combat missions in Iraq, and spoke about how I could best serve the state of Michigan and the country from having that relevant combat experience. It was great, it was unexpected, and I'm honored.
Mm-hmm. And of course, his super, the John Bolton pack is the one that supported you. Now he's got this important job he's about to undertake for the White House. So what did you learn from President Trump's win in Michigan? What did he teach Republicans?
Well, I'll tell you what, it's not about, just like previously, what we just said, it's not about red, it's not about blue, it's about the green. And folks really, and Roseanne did a great job with this on her show, the clip you just showed, that he brought jobs, and he's talking about putting money back into the hands of people who've earned it. He's talked about preserving our Constitution, putting America first, and the concerns that real people had in the state of Michigan are the same concerns that our president is fighting for. And this is what people really care about, not what the talking heads or the coastal elites are saying or dictating. People in the state of Michigan were hurting, and we're beginning to take the first steps in this long comeback heading home.
Sure. You know, John, the Democrats seem to be on the wrong side of the tax cut issue because they're trying to convince everybody it's a bad thing. It's only helping big corporations and really rich people. That just is not right. What's the story from Michigan?
Well, I'll tell you what. Nancy Pelosi called these crumbs, and she's since backtracked from those statements. But when you take a look at what these bonuses have meant to individual people in the state of Michigan, that's a new set of tires on the car because our infrastructure and our roads are falling apart. That's more clothes put on the backs of your kids. That's paying off the credit card a little bit faster from Christmas and the holiday season. This is heating your house when we've had cold weather this season. This is real money for real people. And also in the state of Michigan, jobs are coming back from Mexico. We weren't talking about this 2 years ago. And I'll tell you what, if Hillary Clinton had delivered on her, had been elected and had delivered on these promises like Donald Trump's delivering on his, then she'd have got a Nobel Prize too. But Donald Trump is delivering on his promises and the people of the state of Michigan are benefiting in their wallets.
You know, so interesting, you bring to the table a very, an awe-inspiring resume. You are the CEO of Renaissance Global Logistics. You took a $35 million company, made it $137 million in revenue while creating 100 additional jobs. You start your career in West Point. You fly for over 700 hours in combat in Iraq, all building towards this moment. And imagine for me, this might be something you thought of all along. Am I correct?
Absolutely not. I'll tell you quite frankly, I've always lived by my core values, faith and family, God and country and service before self. And that's what led me to continue my service. I have a passion for service and I understand that too many people have died for me to be able to live in this great country. I have an obligation, not an option, to continue my service. And because I've been able to serve, I want to go serve again. I want to go serve because I don't believe that we have enough combat veterans on the floor of the U.S. Senate who understands how to keep Americans safe. And that's actually why John Bolton endorsed me, because he understands that I have the relevant experience to make critical decisions when it comes to our national security. And I aim to serve again when I get to Washington, well, for Michigan and for the U.S.
All right. John James talking about the endorsement by John Bolton. John, thank you very much for joining us live today from Detroit.
Thank you for having me.